Look, the Tara Reade story is threatening to take down Biden's campaign, but the media is still refusing to talk about it. Why? Why? Okay, so we know, give me the facts. This just came out this week. We know that she told her story to her neighbor contemporaneously with when it happened. She told the next people who hired her to also be a staffer about it, and that person had to assure her that kind of thing doesn't go along with this politician. The Larry King. I mean, so give me your take on this. What is it with the Me Too movement? What is it with progressives that are so idiotic and tribal in the way they see the world that we're going to treat this woman differently with this over? Look, if I was in trial with this facts, there's no question I would win the trial. But the CNN won't even report the story.
Right. And CNN, in fact, actually went back through their archives and they removed that old Larry King tape from their archives online. So you can't even get it anymore if you didn't already have it. So CNN is actively trying to protect Joe Biden for whatever reason it is. Well, that makes no sense either.
But here's what we're going to hear. This is what we hear all the time. Oh, well, don't you want him instead of Trump? Right. Oh, yeah. How many bad we do bad stories on Trump all the time. But we got to call balls and strikes. It's not only that. It's almost like the guy's cracking up. I've said this before and I'll say it again. I don't think he will make it to the election. I really don't. The last ad that I saw was, wasn't an ad, it was a video where his wife is doing all the talking and he's looking at the camera like he's got brain damage. And so why are we protecting this man that we know did this? There is zero question in my mind he did this. With these facts, any jury would come back and say, yeah, come on, Joe. And this wasn't a minor issue. He penetrated her with his hand, reached down her skirt and penetrated her and then said, oh, well, I thought you really liked me when she pushed him off. Well, I mean, how do we say that's OK? It's not OK for Trump and it's not OK for this cat.
Well, and that's what people don't understand either. Well, wouldn't you rather have this than Trump? The answer is, why do we even have to choose between one or the other?
Exactly.
We had a much better option before the establishment came out and made sure that Biden got it. There are other parties that are not Democrat or Republican that are running candidates, hopefully about to pick some better candidates than what they've got. But this is not our only option, and that's the trap most people fall into. It's either Democrat or Republican. It doesn't have to be.
Right. You don't think Obama knew this?
Oh, absolutely.
You don't think Obama knew that? Yeah. How long did it take Obama? This is the guy. He's been with him 8 years. Obama knows the guy he knows the guy has dementia and he knows this stuff is existing. But at the end of the day, he pushes Bernie out of the way. Obama and the DNC. He makes his telephone calls. We have to stop Bernie. He's going to kill our party. And now we're left with this knucklehead. That's where we are right now. And that's the DNC at work again, right?
Oh, 100%. We've known this. But the big problem with this story for Joe Biden is that even the people who say, well, isn't Biden better? They're now, in light of all the new facts that have come out in the last 5 days, they're now also saying, well, listen, her story does follow the same other stories we've seen in the past that all turned out to be credible. The telling of friends, the telling of parents, the telling of neighbors, all of those people coming together to corroborate this story almost verbatim from what Tara Reade said. Even the doubters have said that is what typically does happen.
What is MSNBC doing with this? I don't even watch it anymore. What are they doing with this story?
I don't watch them either, but I haven't seen people posting clips. That's not to say maybe they aren't, but I'm not seeing it through the social media that I go through, and I follow a wide range of people
okay,
on social
here's
media.
My point. Here's my point. We're at a crossroads right now. We have a chance to do something. There's an entire movement. I'm not sure who's behind the movement, but it is to stop Biden. That's it.
Right.
You know, stop Biden. Let's get somebody else in there that has a chance. But, you know, your theory has been that the Republicans have known about this for a long time.
Right.
They've held it back. They're going to launch it later. Right. So you're telling me at this point, CNN went out of their way to make the story disappear, at least in their venue. Is that
right? They've deleted it from their archives. And so that also shows that they knew, CNN knew they had this. right? They may have forgotten about it, but there were people at CNN who knew this existed. They knew right where it was. They knew how to get rid of it in a pinch, and that's exactly what they did. So maybe CNN was the one planning on releasing this later down the road.
No, I don't think that at all. CNN has a love affair with the DNC.
But it makes no sense because CNN, the only reason they're still alive today is because people tune in to see a stupid thing Trump said. They get rid of Trump, they're going to lose half of their already horrible ratings at CNN. Yeah. So that's a lose-lose situation on their side. But again, Biden, he's the merger guy, a big corporate guy, so he's going to take care of their parent companies.
But with MSNBC, of course, it's the Comcast story. MSNBC loves him because Comcast loves him because he's going to make sure that they don't mess around with the monopoly that Comcast is building. And Joe Biden made his promise. He says, I'm not going to let that happen.
Right. Yeah. Nothing will fundamentally change with Joe Biden's words. But this is a real story. This is a credible story. And if Biden Biden doesn't drop out now, then he's tanking Democrats.
I invite the knucklehead tribal progressives who don't understand how bad this is. That we're looking, Alyssa Milano. Can you imagine? this woman goes after everybody on this and stays silent about this. What does it do to the Me Too movement? I think it had some credibility problems. And it's going to get worse if they don't come out and talk about it.
Right.